So guys, Solid Striper here. Peter and I are on our way to Microcenter, and we're gonna go and build our streaming PC. It's about an hour away, it's quite the drive. But this store, all right, this video is not sponsored by Microcenter, but this store is completely worth it. They give us discounts, they hook us up with great deals, and they got really, 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 really good components there. So yeah, we're on our way to Microcenter.
Make them think.
In 10 miles, take exit 103 to merge onto CA55 South toward Newport Beach.
One more time!
Alright, we pretty much just ate like the worst meal ever.
What do we eat?
That shit was disgusting. Straight up trash. Straight up trash. We should have gone to Subway. Inside of it. There is a Subway inside this car wash. You wash your car. And stay fresh.
Thank you. want to walk through how you different apartments from it.
They have the G502.
You know, Logitech. These are all Logitech options. The 502 is my recommendation for most people. If you can find a Proteus version, which probably doesn't exist anymore, it's pretty good. The G602, and that'd be kind of neat just yet.
And right here I have all the wires too. Like,
yeah, multiple Ethernet cords here. Like, multiple options. And you know, the crazy, crazy long options for the Cat 7s. These are all like Wi-Fi solutions for people who want to have like a networking for devices that don't originally have it. I don't know if you can find 7 for Cat 7 here. Do most stores don't only carry Cat 6s or Kicks?
Cat 5e.
Wow. So, this place actually has 3D modeling machines just right here, ready to buy. If you guys want to buy like 3D modeling systems, like this is something that, 3D, that these things can build. And there's one working right now. So check it out. You put the material in, and you design it properly, right? And like, for example, this thing right here is building. This looks like a robot. You know what I think it is? I think it's Cloud from Final Fantasy VII. The body and shape is kind of like Cloud Strife. The way his arms are is what a dead giveaway for that. So this is designing from that material here. You see that? So yeah, dude. Microcenter, bro. Hey, here's the material too. You got this material, like plastic, aluminum, and all that ready right here. I'm not sure if it's all like plastic and things like that. But check out, you have so many options for material. And 3D modeling just right here. It's probably gonna take, I think it's gonna finish at 4:30, So this store also has like a wider variety of like classic gaming options. Like you have the Commodore 64 before the Super Nintendo Classic was even a thing. You can, you have a wide variety of like even retro gaming here too. Classic. This is a PS4 section, by the way. That's all it is. Controllers. If you have a classic console, you got options too. Some science projects. And yeah, and if you want some gamer shades, they have like $25 options here, guys. This is sick. That's it. So in this store, for all of your like mobile computing needs, they pretty much have every option available as far as like gaming and everyday just business class use. That's it. When a lot of us think about like gaming laptops, like when it comes to Acer, the first thought people think about is the Acer Nitro 5. But in reality, Acer has a really, really crazy system called the Acer Helios Predator. And check this out. It's a fully modern device, and it's bulky, dude. It is bulky. Check it out. It's got a 9750H, but I think the graphics card is a full-size RTX 2080. It's no max speed or any of that stuff. And here's the coolest part. You can actually pull this back. And you hear like a little sound, like it activates like keyboard mode. And the keyboard is, it travels really good, so it feels great. So, 144Hz monitor. This thing is a beast. What is this coming? So we have the motherboards here. Well, these are all graphics cards, right? Alright, so here's the meat of the store for me. You have the AMD graphics cards over there, all the 5600, 5700, 50. No, I don't think they have a 5700, but they have the 5700 and the 5500. Here, check this out. 2060 is just hanging out right here. Like, we got 6060, 6060 Ti. So, I'm probably gonna go for this, the OC edition, as far as my build, just because I do. Who knows if I wanna use that machine for gaming in the future, you know, for someone else to use it with. Check this out, these are worth all the big boys, man. A 2080 Ti, the Kingpin edition, $1,900.
Right here, yeah, like, let's see, I think this is a 2080 Ti. These are all of the 2080, 2080 Ti options. There's some that come with water blocks already. This one's a, what the hell is this one? 2080 Super, and it's thick. It's only 700, and the Ti version's $1,000 more. That's ridiculous. And then right here, we have motherboards. So we have the B4 series, B450 X, for AV. I think we're joining the AV options. Yeah. So check this out. You can actually get a full machine that's like big, smaller than this box, like a full-on ready-to-go machine. And check this out. These are they're called Intel NUX. The NUX series are mobile-based systems. They're for people who want the power of like nearly the power of a desktop CPU or performance. So what they do is they build this form factor. It's really small. It can fit anywhere. You can carry it everywhere. It's super sick. So we have all these Intel NUC options. And they're not cheap. They're like 400, 600, but you get power to go. That's a Pentium Gold. That thing is people budget friendly zone. These things are incredible. The performance you get out of these is insane. Then we have all the Core series CPUs. So if you wanted to do like an Intel rig or whatever, you have that as an option. And then of course, same thing with AMD stuff next to it, you have all the Intel options. So the prices are pretty good. You have 9400F, which is pretty good for gaming. The 9600K is just as good as the 9700K in most games. Probably behind like 12 frames and all that. And then we have the big boy, the 9900K, I believe. Yeah, the K, I'm not sure if they have the KS is here. They're really hard to find, regardless. But yeah, we got these are all the CPUs for AMD. So you have your Ryzen 5s. He has some Threadrippers. This is a 3970X. For those people who can't even find one, they got two of them right here. Now the question is, 3600, 2600, or 2700X, or 3700X? That's the real question. And now looking at it, now that I see it, I'm so scared. Alright, cool. We have all these options. People have been telling me, go for a B450, save the money, or if you can, some B350s actually do the job. But I don't want to deal with incompatibility issues. I don't have enough time to have my full rig down time-wise. So, just for the sake of time, I'm going to try to get one that's already ready to go. I don't want to deal with BIOS updating, any of that bullshit. I want something I can just plug and play. End of story. So, yeah, B450s. Probably a Tomahawk edition, if anything. Yeah, just check those out. Just get a wide variety. This is so sick. You have all of these motherboards just kind of hanging out. So many options. And then, you know, you have the 3 series. They have economic options. They have, like, the really nice options, like the Xbox 70H. That was nice. Alright, so we're done with our shopping spree here at Microcenter. So we ended up choosing an 8-core 2700X CPU just because for future-proofing, you know, ensuring that I get maximum performance over time. I know the 3700X was the one I wanted to go for, but I decided that I save a little money and I just go a little more extra for the most important part of the system, which is the capture card. So the CPU is great, getting good performance overall. We have that going for us. Choosing for graphics card, just because I don't really need much of a graphics card. I'm not gonna be gaming off this thing. This is just gonna be doing for videos. And in the future, if someone wants to use this for gaming, we have some gaming capability as well. And as for RAM, I'm using the same RAM that I have on my main rig, Ripjaws 16 gigabytes of RAM, 3200 megahertz. That's our RAM selection. As far as an SSD, I'm choosing the Inland, I believe is what's called, Inland SSD. Inexpensive, gives me about a 500 gigabyte SSD. That's just to save money. Cooling, thermal paste, you won't get any better than this. For the motherboard, I have a B450 Aeros Pro Wi-Fi. Just because I don't know the networking situation for this machine, I'm gonna try to get it networked as far as like overall, like straight wire. That's gonna be the answer for that. So Aeros B450 for the motherboard. That's what's up with that. And then for the power supply, 650 watts power spec. I wasn't the best fan of this thing, but for the money, it's not that bad. And it does have bronze certification, 80 plus, and all that cool stuff. Finally, most important part of the whole rig, I made sure I got myself a 4K 60 Pro to ensure that I got maximum performance on stream. This whole fucking build is literally to improve the stream quality, and I won't have to worry about ever dropping frames again. I'm gonna be playing at maximum settings all the time. Here we go. And of course, for the case, the good old NZXT 510. It doesn't get any better than that. As far as budget, performance, it's just a really good case. All right, so this is all Strifer.